After Effects is a program for creating motion graphics and visual effects that is used by professionals. I'm a professional in this program, so I can tell you how to cope in After Effects. When you first enter a program and look at the interface, you want to close it, run away, never come back. To prevent this from happening, you need to be patient and learn the program. For this purpose, I have prepared a detailed and interesting After Effects course for you at the link in the description. Any project starts with an idea, of course. You can look it up in video or photo format on the internet, but it's better to come up with an idea yourself. My idea came up while walking down the street. I just found such a scoreboard and it seemed interesting to realize my idea. I will tell you right away that you will need plugins. I will leave the list of useful and necessary in the work with the program plugins in the description. After a small digression, I can begin. What idea came to my mind? The scoreboard needs to be duplicated, change color and add glow. The background needs to be blurred and change color. To the trim, add information about it and everything is ready, but it's not really so simple. Go into the program, create a composition and add the footage. Use the sliders to crop the spheres on the right and left and use Ctrl+Shift+X to crop the composition. I advise you to rename the layers for your convenience using Enter. You can use the Rotate Brush tool to duplicate this part of the scoreboard, where for best result I use a pen tool. Copy the footage and make a pro composition from it. Go back to your main composition. Use the pen tool to cut out the first frame of the scoreboard. Now go to the layer options and open the mask options. Here, click on the clock and scroll it throughout each frame with this slider. Frame by frame, make a mask on the wall footage. Duplicate this composition. Move it under the previous one. Add the extent effect to the layer and here set the value to 0. Go back to the main composition. Now, here, lower the borders of this mask a little bit and you are almost done. And add the glow effect. You need to tweak it a little bit. Go back to the main composition and make the layer's blend parameter to screen. If you don't have the settings, you can fix it here. Done. Why did I make this mask? To do tricks like that. You can, with the Extend plugin, make any color you want, and by limiting the area, you don't turn the whole world into madness. I'm going to do the same thing with the numbers, and to avoid having to customize all the effects again, you can just copy and paste. The second stage is blurring background. This can be done not only using the camera, but also using the depth scanner and depth of field plugin. I will tell you in detail how bokeh works in the next video. Duplicate the footage and hide all layers except this one. Add the scanner and configure it. The settings may be different for everyone, but you should only know that everything behind the main object should be black and the main object should be white. Go to File, Export, Add Render Queue and render this layer in MP4 format. After rendering, delete the layer with the scanner and upload the finished file. Now, using a mask, I will circle the scoreboard and animation the mask for an accurate result. Move the depth map layer to the very bottom and add an adjustment layer. Learn everything you need to know about layers in my course. Now you need to add a file depth of field and configure it. Depth layer, the layer you render it in order for After Effects to recognize what should be in the blur. Radius, blur strength, and focal point the area that needs to be emphasized. By selecting this crosshair and placing a dot on an object, you will get everything but the object blurred. Knowing this, you can customize it the way you like. For a saturated picture, you need the Extend plugin, so you don't have to add several effects. Just add one where you can change both saturation and brightness. Another option is to create chaos on video. Simply by marking the clock opposite white, I change it to green, then after a while to yellow, then to red. It turned out to be crazy in the frame, but I will refuse ready, and it looks unusual. To complete the third step, I will need tracking. Right click on the footage, track and stabilize, track motion. You have a small square. I enlarge it and place it on the part that will be easiest for the program to recognize. The inner square should contain this very part, and the outer one a little larger. On the right side of the screen, click on this arrow and every frame will be processed to right side. I will do the same in the other direction. I'll be attaching the text to the trim, so I'll create the text and cut it to where the trim appears. And in edit target, I'll choose this text and apply it on to access. Now the text moves with the frame, but this is corrected by the same anchor point or every frame correct manually in the parameters of layer. You can add the glow to the text for a beautiful effect. And in the right panel, the text can be changed from white to another. And everything seems to be ready, but there is no beautiful manifestation. Add an adjustment layer and give it a fastness blur. Make the settings. Quality, sharpen. Iris scale 30, scale X and Y 50. And in the iris tab, iris shape circle, OK, 3. But now the problem is all the video is blurry. To do this, you can make the animation in the program. Animation is created so that certain data on a layer can be changed over time. Go to the blur layer effect options and click on the globe next to the iris scale parameter. After 2 seconds, change to 0. There's animation, but to add smoothness, select the keys and press F9. You need to add crop and color correction. Select all the layers and create a pre-composition. Go to this parameter and mark the clock next to the scale item. You have a point at the beginning with a scale of 100. After 2 seconds, put the 120. Now there's a beautiful approximation with the appearance of picture's clarity. For the final, you need color correction. Create a new adjustment layer and add limiter color to it. Play around with the settings and do what you want. Also, don't forget about my quiz where you can learn such things. Come again.